Morning, students. Welcome to Dr. B. Ranganath, IIT JEE NEET Academy. So this is my YouTube channel. So please subscribe my YouTube channel and share it. So myself, Dr. B. Ranganath, chemistry faculty. Students, in the chemical kinetics chapter, for IIT level mainly, repeatedly asking one problem based upon the parallel reactions in first order reaction. So before going to solving of that problem, so we must know about the at least what are parallel reaction. What is parallel reaction in first order reaction? In this chemical kinetics students, so here, A is the reactant gives rise to product. B is the product. Okay, so this is reactant. These are product. So here in this equation, what is the rate for in this? So rate is equals to minus d of concentration of A by dt. That is equals to K into concentration of A. This is first. This is general rate of the reaction. For first order. So here first order. What are parallel reactions? What are parallel reactions? For example, student, so here I am taking A. Here takes place two types A to B and another one is takes place B to A to C. So these are two types. So here its rate is K1. Here its rate is K2. Okay. In this parallel reaction, so these are called parallel. So parallel reactions. In this parallel reaction, what is the rate for in this A to B? So here, its rate is equals to minus D of A by dt is equals concentration of A by dt is equals to K1 into concentration of A. So here A to C means its rate is equals to minus d of concentration of A by dt. That is equals to K2 into concentration of A. So here we must consider only reactant. So what is its order of reaction? The sum of powers of concentration terms in the reactant only. So that's why I consider only reactant. So minus d of A by dt by is equals to K1 A, K2 A. So here, so in this total average minus d of concentration of A by dt is equals to nana. So here K1, what is average? K1 into concentration of A plus K2 into concentration of A. So here which one is common? Concentration of A is common. Therefore K1 plus K2 into concentration of A. So this is the average rate for in this parallel reaction. So here effective rate is equals to effective rate. It's called effective. Effective rate is equals to effective rate average is equals to K1 plus K2. So its order is effective order. Which one is effective order? Its effective order is 1 because of we are going to discuss about first order reaction. Effective order is equals to 1. So this is parallel reaction for average rate of reaction. So here in this any examination point of view based upon the parallel reaction, we can calculate the percentage of B, percentage of C, given rate constant K1 and K2. We can calculate how to calculate percentage of B, percentage of C. So here, what is percentage of B? What is percentage of C? So in this parallel reaction, we can calculate percentage of B first. Percentage of B. What is the percentage of B? That is equals to, so here in this reaction, A to B means K1. A to C means K2. So here it's we can calculate percentage of B means, so the percentage of B is equals to concentration of B by concentration of B plus concentration of C. So this is the general formula. So concentration of B divided by concentration of B plus concentration of C because of average. So here it can be directly, I wrote directly, it's constant, K1 is rate constant for the A to B, and K1 plus K2, this is the percentage of B. So therefore, percentage of B is equals to K1 by K1 plus K2 into 100. So this is the percentage of B, student. How to calculate percentage of C? So therefore, percentage of C is equals to, so here, how to form in this parallel reaction, A to C means what is the rate constant K2. So therefore, K2 divided by K average, K1 plus K2 into 100. So this is the percentage of C and percentage of B. Okay, so here, this is the introduction. And next, in the previous year question, so here, this is the very important question. A substance undergoes first order decomposition, student. The decomposition follows two parallel first order reaction. It's clearly given two parallel first order reaction. So here K1, here K2. So A2B is K1, A2C is K2. So here rate constant for the first order, first rate constant is K1 is equals to given 1.26 into 10 power minus 4 seconds. K2 also given. We can calculate the percentage distribution of B and C. How to calculate percentage of distribution? Percentage of distribution for two parallel reactions is equals to K1 by K1 plus K2 into 100. Percentage of distribution of C is equals to K2 by K1 plus K2 into 100. So therefore, here K1, K2 is given. We can calculate the percentage distribution of B and C. So which one is the correct option? So here, write down given. Which one is given in this parallel reaction? So here, this is the parallel reaction, Nana. This is the parallel reaction. So here K1, here K2. So K1 is given, which one is given? K1 means 1.26 into 10 to the power of, 1.26 into 10 to the power of minus 4 second inverse. And K2 also given, K2 is equals to, so here K2 means 3.8 into 10 to the power of minus 5. 3.8 into 10 to the power of minus 5. Second inverse. Okay, for parallel path reaction, what is its average? Write down for parallel path reaction. For parallel path reaction, for parallel path reaction, K average. So K average is equals to what? K1 plus K2. That is equals to what is K1? 1.26 into 10 to the power of minus 4 plus 1.3.8 into 10 to the power of minus 5. So here second inverse. Here student 10 to the power of minus 4, 10 to the power of minus 4. You can convert this 10 to the power of minus 4 in 5 into 4. So there that is equals to 1.26 into 10 to the power of minus 4 plus. This can be written as 0.38 into 10 to the power of minus 4. It's correct or not? Okay. So here, which one is common 10 to the power of minus 4? So therefore, 1.26 plus 0.38. So into 10 to the power of minus 4 is the common. So here, 1.26, 0.38 is the here 4, here 6, 1.64. So that is equals to what is the value? 1.64 into 10 to the power of minus 4 second inverse is the rate average, student. If you can calculate the rate average, you can easily calculate the percentage distribution of B and percentage distribution of C. Okay, so here, how to calculate percentage of distribution of B? Write down percentage distribution of B is equals to, what is the formula? So here K1 by K1 plus K2. So what is its K1, student? So given K1 is given. So here 1.26. 1.26 into 10 to the power of minus 4 divided by average 1.64 into 10 to the power of 1.64 into 10 to the power of minus 4. So second get cancelled, 10th power minus get cancelled. So 1.26 by 1.64 is the 0.768 ma. Okay, this is percentage distribution of B. So therefore, percentage of distribution of B is equals to 0.768 into 100. So that is equals to, what is the percentage distribution of B? 76.8 is the percentage distribution of B. You can calculate next percentage distribution of C. Okay, what is percentage distribution of C? So here percentage distribution of C is equals to, what is the formula? K2 by K1 plus K2 means K2 by rate average. So that is equals to, what is the value for K2 here? 3.8. So 3.8 into 10 to the power of minus 5 seconds inverse divided by K average equals to 1.64, I think 1.64 into 10 to the power of minus 4. So here second inverse get cancelled. 10 to the power of minus 4, 10 to the power of minus 4 get cancelled. 3.8 by 1.64 into 10 to the power of minus 1. So that is equals to 3.8 divided by 10 means 16.4. Okay, so 3.8 by 16.4 gives the, what is the value here? You can calculate 0.2317. Okay, so therefore percentage of C is equals to 0.2317 into 100. That is equals to 23.17. Okay, so which one is the exact answer? Which one is the exact answer for your question? So percentage of B is 76.83, C is 23.76. So this is the answer, student. This is previous question. This type of questions are very important, Nana. So please practicing based upon the parallel reaction. Okay. So if the two parallel reactions are given in first order reaction, how to calculate composition of means percentage of distribution of B and percentage distribution of C by using this rate average. So this is the parallel reactions in chemical kinetics chapter, students. Okay. So thanks for watching, my dear student. Please subscribe my YouTube channel. So this is very useful for those who are preparing mainly for the IIT and NEET level aspirants. And it is also useful for local engineering examinations like Karnataka CET, Maharashtra CET, and MCET. Okay. So I have 13 years experience in this field, students. So I was worked as a various corporate institutions in India for IIT and NEET level faculty. So please subscribe my channel and like it and share it. Thank you.